On?
Yep.
So, here we are today, making some protein fluff. We owe this all to Martin Birkin and leangames.com, in case anybody else ever watches this. I'd like to put a full disclaimer out there. So, what we got here is 16 ounces of strawberries, frozen, obviously. I have 8 ounces of water in here. I'm going to kind of slowly feed this in once we start mixing the strawberries. Sometimes you have to kind of jostle them up. Get them sucked down still. So we put the lid on, put this bad boy on high, so it's plugged in.
It should be,
as you can see, right about here, it starts to slow down. The strawberries don't really want to go anymore. This is usually when I add the rest of the water. It usually helps a little bit. Sometimes, there we go. Sometimes you actually have to stop the blender, wiggle things around, restart, and get it going again. Let's see if we can't do that now. Take one of the whisks. All I'm doing now is just kind of moving some of these chunks that are keeping it from blending properly on the bottom around so we can keep the blender going. Should pretty much be able to get this to run. This run through here. Throw the lid back on.
Hey.
There we go. Alright, so if you see, again, this is the exact science. I'm trying to keep the water to strawberries like 2-1. Once you start having that kind of funnel effect, a tiny bit more water in there. Which made it die, apparently. Once you get that funnel effect going, that's pretty much when you know you're good. Put this on for safety. There we go. That's what you want to see. So again, I wasn't too exact in the water. It ended up being a little over 2-1, but that's where you want to go with that. So now that we have our strawberry mix ready, we're going to take our good old casein protein, slow digesting, which is why we can take so much of it here. We're going to put in 2 scoops today. So just get a good size scoop out, put your mixing bowl, let it sit right down there. Next good size scoop, in the bowl, we're done. So we're going to add in our strawberry concoction over here. I personally like to throw a banana in there as well. Chocolate strawberry banana is pretty tasty, but low on fruit today. So, it's kind of like to spread it around a little bit. I don't think this actually does anything, but it makes me feel like I'm making it better for some reason.
Oh, look at that!
Let's go ahead and put our hands on. And when you first introduce the, what are these called? I have no idea. These are whisks?
The whisks?
To the mixture, you want to do it slowly. For the most part, we're going to move pretty quick. For the most part, you're going to want to move the whisks pretty quickly. But at the beginning, to keep all the powder from flying out and making a huge mess all over your kitchen or wherever you're making this at, hallway at a gym, you're going to want to introduce it slowly so you don't make a huge mess. So, now, at the slower speed, it doesn't really have enough power to spin it for you. Let's kind of slowly nurse it along. See how the mixture is kind of, I don't know, making itself happen in there. And once it gets going a little bit and it gets a little bit better blended, I can shift it over to the sides so you can get all that protein off the side of the bowl there. And it all starts spinning on its own. So at this point, it's mixed up thoroughly enough that we can actually bring up the speed. And again, this is all Martin's secret, but once you bring the speed up to like 8 or 9, is when it actually starts fluffing. So at this point, it might be kind of hard to see on the video. We'll slow it down here in a second. I'm going to bring the speed a little more. Good measure. I'm going to throw a drop of water in there. So I'll slow it back down so it's easier to see here. At this point, you can see we have kind of like a pudding mixture right now. And this is personally, this is where I like to have it because it's like ice cream. But it's not as filling and it's not as satisfying to like a hunger craving at this level. So we're gonna keep whipping it for a couple more minutes. And as you can kind of see here, when you let it sit in a spot, that's when it really kind of starts to fluff up. So what I like to do is turn it up and hold it in place. And slowly kind of work it around the bowl. And as you can see now, we had a small volume at the beginning. We've got, you know, roughly a third of the bowl full now. So again, just let it work around the sides here. Turn it up a little higher here. And then I just kind of let it go loose again. Like I said, I don't really know if there's a better way to do this, but this is the way I do it. And it seems to work pretty good for me usually. When it goes loose like that, it's actually introducing a lot of air, which is what's causing it to fluff up. We'll slow it back down. You can see it's kind of volumizing around the sides there. Again, slow it down, work it through. You can see now coming off the whisk there, it's actually pretty fluffy, pretty light. Now you can see you got a really good fluffy texture. You know, if you gross my finger in there. It's like somewhere between ice cream and cotton candy is the best way I can explain it. Like marshmallowy almost. Mm-hmm. I like to let it go a little faster one more time. And I slow it down again for one last kind of pull through. This time I go a little slower and let it really kind of hold at each spot. I'll slide it over to the middle, make sure everything's pretty evenly distributed. Slide it back out, slow it down a little here for the end. Make it look prettier. Or not, maybe it won't look any prettier. So at this point, we've got a nice thick fluff with roughly 50 grams of protein, 200 some odd calories from protein, and we've got a good maybe 100 grams or 100 calories from the strawberries. So I've got roughly 350 calories here. Very healthy, incredibly filling. It's all air. It sits like a brick in your gut, and it's great for you, and it satisfies that sweet tooth ice cream kind of craving you might get when you're trying to eat paleo.
Right, and all that in 9 minutes.